Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning in for this Paranormal Pit Stop. Tonight, we'll be exploring a historic hotel located off West Austin Street in the heart of downtown Jefferson, Texas, that boasts the title of being the oldest continuously operating hotel in the whole of the state, famous for its hosting of a number of notable names, including the likes of Ulysses S. Grant, Oscar Wilde, Rutherford B. Hayes, Lady Bird Johnson, and Steven Spielberg, and purported to harbor a number of restless spirits. Are you prepared to delve into the history and hauntings of the Excelsior House Hotel? Historically, initial settlers to the area would begin arriving in 1840, with one William Perry, who boasted a history in shipping and dredging, playing an integral role in the development of early Jefferson. As the community's populace grew, a need for lodging would arise, and in 1858, Perry would establish a hotel called the Irving House, which makes up the wooden portion of our modern building. Following the election of Abraham Lincoln in November of 1860, in February of 1861, Texas would vote to secede from the Union, and while several other towns were razed to the ground when New Orleans was blocked by the Union in 1862, Jefferson would be spared. Following the Civil War, Jefferson would begin the process of rebuilding. Perry would add the corner brick portion to his hotel. In 1867, the property was sold to William Tumlin, and following Tumlin's passing in 1869, it would be acquired by A.A. Tarun. The hotel would continue to change hands over the years, eventually landing under the ownership of one Mrs. Kate Wood in 1878. Following her passing in 1907, it would be acquired by her daughter Mrs. Amelia McNeely, and in 1920 it was bequeathed to George S. Niedermeyer and would remain in his family until 1954, following which it was purchased by a Mrs. James H. Peters. Mrs. Peters' ownership of the hotel would welcome a number of additions, some of which included two solariums, garden landscaping, a front planter, and a new door to the northeast wing, alongside remodels to a number of guest rooms in the southwest wing. In 1961, the aged lodging was purchased by the nonprofit Jesse Allen Wise Garden Club, who would issue a number of restorations before reopening the site to the public in 1963. The hotel remains in the hands of the club to this day, in association with the Excelsior Foundation, and offers 15 historic guest rooms, a ground floor lobby and museum, and a grand ballroom and fountain courtyard, which hosts numerous prominent annual weddings and events. While official statements issued by both the club and the workforce maintain that the hotel isn't haunted, and that association with such activity is simply the stuff of legends, many claim this is purely to avoid unwanted attention or detraction, and frequent reports of encounters with the inexplicable across the property persist, with staff and visitors describing strange knocking sounds from within walls, instances of toilets flushing on their own, phantom cigar smoke, and accounts of overnighters experiencing disturbing nightmares. One popular tale surrounding the hotel tells of Diamond Bessie Moore, also known as Annie Stone, a young working girl who, on January 21st of 1877, was shot and killed in the forest just outside of Jefferson. While it's now believed her murder was facilitated by her husband, Abraham Rothschild, no one was ever found guilty of the heinous crime, and it's theorized her restless soul returned to the hotel where she may have worked previously. Her presence has been sensed in various rooms and usually brings with it the strong aroma of old-fashioned perfume. Also reported across the property is the entity of a decapitated man carrying his head in his hands, who's usually spied on the second floor, and a spectral woman in black carrying a baby, who some claim will steal things left lying around, and whose manifestation is always described as utterly terrifying. In room 212, the President Ulysses S. Grant room, guests have reported the closet door handle rattling, the bathroom door swinging open on its own, and the spirit of a soldier spied in the reflection of the oval mirror. In room 213, the Rutherford B. Hayes room, those sleeping have been awakened by the sensation of an unseen hand tugging at their covers, and those staying in room 215, the J. Gold room, have described objects moving on their own, the doors slamming shut spontaneously, and instances in which the rocking chair rocks by itself. As an interesting tidbit, when Steven Spielberg stayed in room 215, it's said that he experienced heavy activity, including his luggage literally being thrown at him, and it's even rumored he was awakened in the middle of the night by a ghostly little boy who asked if breakfast was ready. Activity was so strong on site, in fact, that it's told the famous director woke his team, packed his belongings, and left the property, events which are said to have inspired his renowned horror film, Poltergeist. Thanks for joining us on this Paranormal Pit Stop. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Good night.